Hello everyone, welcome back to Conarchy YouTube channel. In our previous videos, you've been learning how to model and design this building, and we've been able to do that perfectly. And today is actually, I think it's going to be our last video we'll be doing for this series. That's to detail our structure. Kind of feel sad we're about to end this, but we all knew it was going to come to this point. So we are going to learn how to detail this structure and produce our detailing for this structure too. So let's get started. But before we do, don't forget to leave us a like for just giving you this good tutorial, and also subscribe to the channel if you've not done that already, and also leave a comment in the comment section for us if there's anything you want to know about or any video you want us to make. Just leave that in the comment section and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. So let's get started. Okay, so this is actually our structure we've been drawing or modeling for this period of time, and we are done with designing it and we know that everything is passing. So as I said earlier, we are going to start off with the detailing. So before we start the detailing, we have to run our analysis. I just opened my model and I think it's already run, so it's locked. So what you have to do now is to start off with our modeling. So our detailing, so this is my Etabs 16 app. I already have my detailing option over here, but with the various options like maybe Etabs 22 or their latest models, some of them, most of them don't have this detailing option in the app. You have to download that detailing software separately. So once you are done doing a model in this version, you transfer the model into that detailing app and you get that detailing. But this is the 16 and I have my detailing here. So all I have to do now is to run my analysis, which is complete, and I'll come to detailing. So with the detailing, the first thing we have to do now is to specify the detailing preferences. So we have detailing preferences over here, and this is a standard unit. We want our units and everything in the metric unit. We want our millimeters, our meters, our length to be in that unit, and our force to can be in tons or maybe say kilonewton. So with how you want your detailing units to be like, you just specify all those over here and you click on OK. So once you're done, you just come back to the detailing again and we will come to the rebar selection rules. So let's come start off with the beams. So these are the rules you are going to give the app to follow to do your detailing for you. So we have our first part, our beam non-seismic part. We can specify the smallest bar size. So let's say you want the smallest bar size of the beams to be 12. So you specify all those diameters over here. You specify all those over here. And also the largest bar size. Maybe you want the largest bar size to be 25. You specify all of that over here. And we have the preferred bar size. So preferred bar size is, you this for with this, you are giving them a range, and the preferred size is what you prefer the app to use if it passes the design. So maybe the preferred bar size will be 16. You specify this throughout over here. But looking on top, you have A, B, C, D, E, F. Right now, you might not know what they mean, but once we start our detailing, we are going to show. So don't forget this part. We have A, B, C, D. So these are like regions or part of the beams that have been given a label. So with this part of the beam, maybe you should provide these diameters of bar, and this is the zone. We have the zone A, zone B, zone C, and these are the for the stirrups, for the stirrups of the beam. These are it. So with this, you have minimum number of bars here. So you can say minimum number of bars four. So you can just be specifying that over here. So for, you can just specify all of that here. Maximum number of bars, you can also specify that. Minimum spacing, you can specify that for the stirrups over here. Minimum spacing, maybe or maybe 100. You can do that, maybe 100 mm. You can specify all of these over here. So now once you are done, you just come to the columns. And you also specify the smallest bar size. Maybe you want your smallest bar size to be 12 for the longitudinal bars, smallest bar size and largest bar size maybe 25, and the preferred bar size maybe 16. And that's the same, these are the ties over here. So with the ties, you can go with 10 throughout, and these are the beam length. So you want to splice the bars at every, maybe at every story, you want to lap the bars over there. So you want to, you change this to every story that you want to slice the bar or lap at every story. Just check this option, minimum number of bars for minimum spacing, maximum spacing. You can just go through all of these and just specify all dots. So we have our PS here. The PS is basically the shear walls that we created. So with that one too, you can specify all these bar size, maybe 12, like just bar 16, everything. You can specify all of these. So once you are done, you just click on OK. And actually the spandrel is actually like the coupling beams, that are joining the shear walls together. That's the spandrel. We didn't really do that in this model, but I just wanted to know, just let you know what we are dealing with when we talk about the spandrels. So once everything is done, we've done both for the beams, column, piers and spandrels, everything. And now you can also set up your drawing sheets, how you want your drawing sheets to look like. Our sheet type, maybe metric, sheet size, your A1 sheet. If you want to change it to the A4 or whatever sheet you want to use, you just change it. You can change all of these too. And this is the default sheet arrangement, or how the sheet is going to look like. Let's just say you already have how your sheet is. You've already done that in your AutoCAD, how you want your sheet to look like. You can just come to the user define and import from the AutoCAD into this Etabs app. It's going to give you that sheet that you've already created from. But I've not done that yet, so I'm just going to use this one. And I'm just going to click on OK. Once you are done with everything, you can start your detailing. So with this, I've already done a previous detailing, but I'm going to overwrite that. So yes, and it's going to look through this model and it's going to detail every element in my structure. So looking at this, we have our floor framing plan over here. These are just the IDs of a beam. So for this beam, 6CB6S1. S1 means span 1. These are just beam IDs given to the beams. So let's start off with the first option over here, drawing sheets component. We have our standard details. We have our typical concrete beam elevation for one span. So it's going to show you how the detailing of one span is going to look like. So this is for our one span detailing. So remember when we were doing our rebar selection, doing our detailing option, we saw some A, B, C, D. So this is it. You have A over here pointing to this bar, connecting to the first bar over here. This bar is going to be at the support, so mostly resisting hugging moment here. Then we have our B to be that bar that we are going to extend here. And we have our G, we have our F over here to be in the middle of the span. We have our D at the opposite side, our H here. So this is it with, and we have that zone A, zone B, zone C with the stirrups. If you remember, this is for the zone A close to the support, zone B a little bit also close to the support, and zone C to be in the mid span. So these are the zones and the how the stirrups will be distributed here. And this is a typical concrete beam elevation for a 3 span. So we have 1, 2, 3. So for 3 spans, this is how the detailing is going to look like. So this is just a typical of how the detailing is going to look like. So we're specifying the A, we have F over here, we have G, we have B, just like that. And it specifies how it's supposed to look like. So if you see value of A and it's specifying 216 mm bars, it means that at this region, this bar will be 16 mm for that beam. So once you are done, you can also look at the beam sections, how it's going to look like. These are typical ones, and we also have a typical for the column. So this is how the column is going to look like. We have our tie zones at A, we have our typical lapping, our lapping over here, how we are going to lap these bars over here, the various stories, and we also have how it's going to end the bars, 90 degrees hook. This is where we end our column at the top over here. So we're showing, and the various zones, zone A, zone B, zone C, is going to show all of that, how the stirrups are going to be in the column. So let's go to beam details. So with this, we have, as I said, this 6CB1. 6CB1 is just a beam ID, and with that beam ID, let me go to the drawing sheet and show you the frame details, frame views, individual frames, and elevation A. So looking at elevation here, we have 6CB1 and this is span 1, 6CB1 span 2, and 6C1 span 3. So this is the 6CB1 and this is the beam over at 6CB1, 3 spans. And let's go back to our table over here. So we have 6CB1, this is span number. So span number 1, span number 2, span number 3. So with that elevation, these are the spans. This is the length, the width, and the depth of that beam. And we have A, B, C, D. We have those alphabets over here. And this beam will have 214mm bars at A, 214mm bars at B, at C you can choose not to provide any bars, at F you can provide these bars and stuffs. So that's it. So with span, the second span at A and B, no bars, C and D, these are the bars you have to provide. And also looking at the stirrups part, we have zone A and zone B, zone C. So they are specifying that at zone B there are no stirrups over there, but that's not really ideal. In construction, we try to provide the stirrups at all the along the entire beam. So that's it for the beams. So let me go to the column details schedule. Okay, so with this, we have our first column, CC1. This is also a column ID. And we have this going to show you how the reinforcement is going to be in the column. So this is the base, and we have one bar starting at the base. We have this, so this is going to be 12 number of 16mm bars in this column, and it's going to go up to the story 2. Then we are going to lap here, and we have another 12 16mm bars here. So that's how the bar is going to be distributed in there. So this is C1, and we have the tie zone A. Tie zone A, that means 10mm bars at 100mm spacing, and just like that for the stirrups. And this is a section with a section A, and the column size is 300 by 300. Yes, that's our C1 column. We have all those over here. So 450 by 450, this is our C2 column, and it's going to show you how the rebars are going to be arranged in that column. So I think, yeah. So these are the various columns IDs. So with the column ID, you're going to look at how the bars are going to be arranged. I think we've already looked at the walls, so I think we can just overlook that for now. Yep, so you can just come onto the column, select the first column over here, that's CC1, and you can also view the cage view of the column once the steel has been arranged, or the steel benders are done with their job. So you can just see how the bars will be arranged in the structure over here. So you can just close that. You can also view that for the wall. And this is how the members or the drawings will look on the drawing sheet. So with this, let me see the concrete column layout. So this is how the concrete columns are going to be on the. So we have our cover notes 2 over here. So you have to read this and to understand that the Etabs app won't be responsible for any interpretation of your detailing and stuffs. So with this, you have to let the a qualified engineer to also check your detailing. But with this detailing of the Etabs, I don't really advise to use the same detailing from the Etabs. You can just copy the Etabs detailing and send it into your AutoCAD and just modify it, or you can just look at your design. Once you know your design, you know the number of bars that is going to pass for this member, you check through the design and everything. You can do your detailing by yourself. You don't have to copy this from the Etabs app. The Etabs detailing is a little bit complex in a way, can't really be understood on the site because of this zone A, zone B, zone C. it's not really reasonable for these construction supervisors, your site engineers, to, you know, understand what this means. So you have to understand this and know how to represent it in your drawing, so you don't have to use the same drawing from the Etabs app. So you can just look for the beam schedule like we did earlier. You can also place this, so this is going to look like on the sheet. So if you imported your own sheet over here, it's going to be in your own sheet format, the schedule for the concrete. So these are general notes for a typical elevation, how the typical columns are going to look like. So that's it for the detail. You can go through and see every part of the detailing you've done. So once you are done, you can also export your drawings, or, you know, just print your drawings. You can do that, select all these options and start export. You can export all these drawings you've done, and once you're done, you can just open them in your AutoCAD app. You can also print all of these, and once you're done, you can just show that in your AutoCAD app and do the various editing to it. So that's it for today's video, and I believe you are probably done with the Build It tutorial series with the Etabs, but I believe we are going to get a complete video from start to scratch, but I won't really be explaining like I've been doing for the tutorial. You get a complete video of how to go about it, your design, and I think we'll be done with the Etabs. Maybe 1 or 2 days we'll be releasing a couple of videos. So that's it for today's video. Don't forget to give me a like. I know I've done a good job, so just give me a like, and also subscribe to the channel and leave a comment for us to, you know, just communicate. Okay, so that's it for today's video. Thank you guys.